what your students know, can do in relation with their various of strength, interest, and background. Okay? This approach goes hand in hand with differentiated instruction that we learned last Saturday, right? How we structure our instruction based on our student needs and life. So in the end, they will be able to acquire or to get all the knowledge that we teach them. That's right. Yeah? Okay. Right, any questions? Yeah, so this is to do. This is a differentiated assessment, the reading differentiated learning that is now also applied to our program. So you need to know about this. So you can use it to do it like in class. Now, what is the difference between assessment and evaluation? Assessment is the ongoing process. So you assess your students during the whole academic year. Okay? After you teach your students, you can give them short quizzes. Or you want to check whether they understand about a concept or two, you give them questions. So it's like the ongoing. They also in class. After you teach them about a topic, then you ask them questions, right? For example, you teach about an elephant. Okay? You teach that elephant has legs. It has a long trunk and big ears, right? And then at the end of that, you want to know whether they understand what an elephant is. So you show them the picture. You ask them, what is this? It's a human, right? What is this? An elephant? How many legs? How many ears are there? Okay? So it's an ongoing process. It involves a variety of methods and tools to measure progress and perform instructional decisions. So from the assessment that you know that if you ask your students about what you have taught, probably in some area they already know about it, but in another area they don't know. So you can design your instruction based on that. Yeah, so if you teach math, they're already good in addition. You need to teach them about subtraction. Then you know in which part of the subtraction that they can understand. That's the use of the assessment. So you don't keep on teaching them addition, but you also introduce the concept of subtraction and know how far they can grasp the concept. And then you go higher in multiplication or even division. Yeah. So it is designed to accommodate students to diversity in learning abilities, learning styles, and ages. So if your students, some of our students are very good with words, okay? And they really like to talk. However, if you ask them to write down their answers, suddenly they don't know anything, right? Not anything. So differentiated learning allows you to assess and evaluate them based on their strength, their learning styles, their abilities, their level of readiness. Of course, we have standard, but how we get our students to fulfill the standard, we can use this. Okay, so you cannot just do one concept for everyone. You cannot do that because we have different students. Yeah. Now, how about evaluation? Evaluation is the judgment or interpretation of assessment data. So from the assessment, from all the assessment in the class that you can evaluate your students. Oh, A is very good in writing. Then when I ask him to draw or to or to talk in front of the glass, he becomes less confident. Okay, so the evaluation that I might used for him later in accordance with the assessment that I've done is probably from in the form of writing. Yeah. Why? Okay. Now, with the evaluation, you go with the with the bigger range, with more holistic assessment. Yeah. So here you can actually evaluate the result of your of the assessments of your students. Then you can make a decision about is your student, does your student have achieved standard or not? Okay. Is your instructional strategies is effective or not? Right. And you can also evaluate the overall success of the learning experience. Have your students experienced and learned the way you should be? Okay? And how is it really helping to acquire the knowledge that he has to acquire or needs to acquire? Right? So that's our duty as a facilitator, as a teacher. We provide them the scaffold, the ladder to reach that potential, to reach his or her potentials. Okay? Here, the evaluation also involves assigning values or grades to students with work based on accessibility criteria. So you have already the criteria, okay? Where we already have what we call as a goal, okay? So children age 3 has to be able to read how many words?
How many groups did you make?
You made groups, right?
Thank you. is one of the most important one, as it is the key to driving the student's ability of learning. The other two keys, such as cultural background of students, including their prior knowledge and experiences, is something to observe, as well as their interest and preferences in the topic of learning.
Okay, good. Any questions? Clear?
As it is, make the So it's specific and regularly. So every student know what they learned that day, what they need to be improved or what they could have. And then for student reflection, we encourage students to reflect what they already learned.
Next up, technology integration. So the key point of this is that we integrate our teaching, specifically assessment, with the technology. So we can use various apps or websites that can help us to generate assessment. And also, there are some platforms that are available for us to use that can adjust the difficulty of the questions based on the level or even their individual performance.
Number one, accommodation for social needs. Our students with social needs can be using extra time using different materials or supporting more technology. This change makes learning fair for everyone. Teacher uses adjustment provision of the students despite their differences in the real in their studies.
Be limited with the time, right? Now, result of technology, or you can design your own assessment, your own worksheet, yeah? Or you can ask them to do things that they like as long as they can acquire that. Now, next one is tracking individual progress. This is quite giving you such a headache if you have like around 15 to 20 students in class, right? The solution is that nowadays we are having the digital tools for this, yeah? And then you also have to maintain your communication and involvement in the assessment process. And it's like what we just learned earlier, you can have the students reflect, right, on which part that they have already understood and which part that they haven't understood. You can improve them. Next one, resource availability. This one involves the collaboration. How we solve it? You can collaborate with your colleagues. Different level or the same level. Your colleagues or your peer teaching partner are the best solution that you can get. Because what? You are all going through the same teaching days, right? You know the difficulties when you face this one, you face that one. Okay, maybe when I teach in grade one and the method A did not work. But probably Miss Irene is also teaching in grade one, right? Using the different method, it works. I can learn. Okay, that's the importance of having a collaboration. Yeah, nowadays it's the days of collaboration and cooperation. Okay. And then you can explore all the different resources that I told you last time. Okay? Lots of free resources. And they're giving, and it is being updated all the time, right? And also assessment tools. Yeah? Next is how to balance differentiation and standard. It's always, the problem is always there. They ask us to go differentiate, but they also give the standard, right? Now, here the most important thing is that you can align your assessment with the learning standard. Okay, if your learning standard tells you that students have to reach like this level of knowledge, then you tailor, you model, you design your assignment that goes with it. Okay, and then you can use rubrics. You can use rubrics. Okay. Because it can encompass a range of skills and knowledge like in one standard of assessment. Next is the resistance to change. The problem is resistance to change. You refuse to change. It's been a comfort zone, right? What should I change? Yeah, that's the problem, not only with you, but with all of us. Okay? Especially when you have students that really match your teaching styles, they enjoy it, and then eventually you get the whole new students who are different from it. It's really, really hard to move on, right? The solution is that we have to keep on training ourselves, learning more and more and more and more. From the school side, you provide training, but from your side, you have to update yourself also. With the different assessment strategies, with you see the success stories of teachers, and also you emphasize because that way you find the benefits for both you and the students. If you enjoy your teaching sessions, right? I guarantee 1000% the students will enjoy your teaching and will learn, right? More for what you know. So that's what you need to do always anyway. Yeah? Now, so overall consideration in assessment and evaluation. First, continuous professional development, like what we did right now. Okay? You
skills in designing and implementing differentiated assessment.
Why? Because things, there's nothing immortal here on Earth, right? Everything keeps on changing. The one that stays forever is the day you travel, right? So here you need to continue your professional development. And then you need to reflect. Okay? You reflect on your assessment data, student outcomes, and then your effectiveness instructional strategies. Okay? You need to make the assessment always, because why? Because students are different, even though they are the same students. Okay? Today they have a good mood, everything went smoothly in class, but tomorrow you can have a chaos. So it's no. So you need to learn from here also. Next, collaborate with learning communities. Okay? Why? Because we could share best practices. Okay, so and also resources and also solutions for differentiated assessment challenges. So here you have your support system. You're not alone. Sometimes you get frustrated, right? In your class with this one student or these two students. Okay? So who you can turn to help? Your colleagues. Or probably if you teach the same class, you can collaborate. Yeah. Yeah, so last one is the input support. Consideration for implementation. These four things. Your communication, flexibility, data informed decision making, so your decision has to be based on the data. That's why we need to put the pre-assessment in the initiated learning. From the data, then you know how many students are visual, how many students are auditory, how many students are reading, how many students are kinesthetic. From there, then you can design your instructional strategies. For example, for students who like to go with visual, who is easy to learn by visual aids, then you put more visual aids. Same thing goes with auditory and kinesthetic. Yeah, from here. Equity. You make sure that your assessment provides fairness. And you also use the opportunities to demonstrate their understanding. Get me through drawing, get me through talking, retelling, or things that deal with movement. Yeah, so this is what you need to consider when you want to apply, when you want to apply to appreciate it. So far, any questions? Anyone have ever tried to appreciate learning? Can you answer that about? Especially with greater rates. Why? To go back again. To what? If you teach in class, who is learning? Teacher or student? Student. Who is more active? Teacher or student?
With
cognitive, social, and emotional development. Recognizing the importance of acknowledging and addressing these differences, Ms. Emma decides to implement differentiated assessment strategies to create a more personalized and effective learning environment for her young learners. Okay? If you are Ms. Emma, what are the steps that you will take to assess them? Okay? You explain how you will do your assessment plan. Okay? Supposed to be you going to be here, but I think the time is not allowing us to do that. So you can do it on at your own pace. After you can do it now, send later, or you can do it second time. This was supposed to be meeting for you. So you can do this. Send it to the email as usual. Yes, Miss.
Meeting for.
Yes.
Meeting.
Meeting for. This is meeting board. Yeah, send us the link only. Yeah, send us the link so we can access it. Okay? Alright. Yes. Sendiri aja. Yeah. Will you go to or later up? I can send it to Miss. Miss Anna, you cannot share yet. Okay, before I go further, do you need the PPT? No, right? You need the PPT? No. Yeah, we're going to do the PPT. Okay? Alright, so later, the name and the start meeting number 4. Okay, do you have any questions? Do you have any questions, right? Okay, if you don't have any questions, I'll end our training here today. I'll see you tomorrow. Please be ready for number 1. Okay, this is the icebreaker. Yeah, so you do the icebreaker before your class.